Barbershop conversation, guys. Feel free to hit the subscribe button. So by now everyone knows what happened to Nipsey Hussle. And before I go off on this monologue, I just want to say this, that before we get presumptuous and say it was black on black crime and just let it play out, let the details play out, the witnesses will come. People saw it, I have no doubt, but I just don't want the narrative to be leading black on black crime, Bloods on Crips, his last tweet. You know, I don't believe people like him die from like gun violence, stuff like that. I mean, it can happen, but in this case, I think it was purposeful, intentional, and planned out. For those of you who don't know, Slauson and Crenshaw is the busiest intersection and the most congested now because they're putting a train through Slauson and Crenshaw. So it's awfully congested. It's hard to rip and run and get out of there. There's a Shell gas station on one corner, Nipsey Hussle's corner. Then on the southeast corner, there's an Arco station. On the northeast corner, there's a bank. And on the northwest corner, there's a check cashing place. And it's congested. It's awfully congested. So I don't believe no one I don't believe the person will get away with this, and we'll get answers soon. You know, just people want to tell, but they want to keep their confidentiality, you know, and that's the code of the streets, you know, and we got to make that uncool at some point, you know, and but I just want to talk about Nipsey Hussle and just so I can have closure, you know. Those of you who follow me on Instagram mostly know how much his album inspired me. You guys know how much I played his album. You guys know how much I saw him as my brother. I saw him as like my equal in terms of wanting to massage our community and actually give tangible assets to our community to make it a greater place. And for those of you who don't know, my Instagram family knows. I actually reached out to Nipsey and tried to collaborate with him on a community center. I was in negotiations for an apartment building that had a church attached to it, and the owner ended up falling out. He didn't want to sell the building, so I said, "Let me collaborate with someone," and I reached out to him, but you know. And I wasn't really, really serious about, not the word serious, but I wasn't really anxious because I knew he and I would cross paths at some point. And that's what it was, man, because he's always in the community. I actually saw him like Tuesday or Wednesday of this week, and I was going to stop because he was at the car wash on Slauson and West. And he had his Bentley truck out there, and they were doing some pickup shots, I can totally tell. And I was going to stop in and say what's up to him, and I said, nah, I'll catch him some other time. And it's happened a couple of times. You know, they did the Puma commercial right here at the Slauson and West, and I actually drove by coincidentally that time as well. And only met him one time. And I told you guys this story prior to this. I told him. He was going to the Chase Bank, and I actually said to him in the Ladera Center by Magic Johnson Star, formerly of Magic Johnson Starbucks, and I said, "You really be in the hood?" And he's like, yeah, I do. And he went into the bank, and I said, "Yeah, we'll link up at some point. I want to holler at you." And we just shook hands and gave that brother half hug and dap and just moved on, you know. And he was real comfortable by himself, you know. I think he may have frequented that Chase Bank quite often because I was the only one that actually said what's up to him. So people have probably got acclimated to him being there. And I want to talk about like the importance of black love, man, and black brotherhood. He stood for something, you know. He stood for what you believe in. He stood for what you strive to get out of your family and out of your community. And, you know, his starting point is unlike many of us, you know, and like some of us, you know. Gangs hustled his way to get to a space where he can bet on himself, and it turned into a handful of mixtapes, and it turned into a debut album, which I thought was the album of the year. You know, I have forcibly put that album on everybody that I know. If you've had a conversation with me about music since last year, February 16th, when the album came out, I forcibly have put that album on you. And, you know, it's just awful, obviously, at the same time. But moreover, his spirit is why it resonates with so many of us. And thousands of us have never met Nipsey Hussle. I wouldn't really, really consider me meeting him like a true interaction or engagement, you know. I never had a conversation with him. I knew at some point we would. I was banking on that just because of our plight in our neighborhood. I would probably bet some point we may be bidding on the same property and he and I may have a conversation, or I'll run into him at an event, maybe a boxing event, you know, maybe a community event, and I'll just have a conversation with him. We'll be introduced where we can just have a casual conversation. I saw him as my equal. You know, I saw him as my brother. You know, and I was in a different phase in my life when Tupac and Biggie were killed. You know, I was too young. I wasn't conscious yet. You know, I was a black child, a young adult, a high teenager, 19 or so. But I wasn't like, I wasn't in the space I am now where I absolutely enjoy and long for like fellowship with my black brothers. And if you, and many of you who subscribe to my channel, we've had a chance to meet, and I always embrace every black man that I know. I always embrace, you know, and say thank you, and I'm very gracious as it relates to that. And Nipsey Hussle was, from what I know of him, was that, you know, and more, you know, because he actually allocated funds. You know, he actually bet on himself. He actually sold an album for $10,000 or $1,000, it was, you know. Jay-Z bought the first 1,000 copies or so, you know. He flipped that money into an album, then flipped that money into the Marathon store. Well, the Marathon store came first, 2017. The album dropped in 2018, and... In 2019 and 2020, he was on the Dr. CB documentary, and it would have been spectacular, and it would have changed lives as if his life is doing now. And, you know, a piece of me doesn't believe that his death will go in vain. I genuinely don't. It will become more passive and passive as time passes. I understand that because we all have lives to live. But I genuinely don't believe his life will be forgotten. He's one of the brightest stars to ever come out of Los Angeles as it relates to the Bloods and Crips, you know. And I'm just thankful for that album, man, because I've told you guys 1,000 times on my channel, his album saved and changed lives, man. I have no doubt. Many of gangbangers have put down their gun listening to Nipsey Hussle's album. I just genuinely believe it, you know. I think that he is a special person, and it's awful that the great ones, many of the great ones, don't live out their full potential, you know, don't live out their complete lives. You know, we can go back to Bob Marley, we can go back to Marvin Gaye. We can go back down to Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, Fred Hampton, and the list goes on and on. Nat Turner, the list goes on and on, right? And I just want to encourage everybody. Don't be afraid. Be strong. Be brave. You know, stand on your square. Believe in yourself. Bet on yourself. You know, Nipsey Hussle went from hustling and slanging t-shirts and CDs on the corner to owning the land in which he hustles on now. You know, I believe that to be a credible and an amazing story. And I just want this to be a lesson, obviously. I want the truth to be unfolded and revealed. And also want us to heal and become better. I don't want us going around killing people and letting the media tell us this was a rival gang that killed the man 3 p.m. I don't believe that, you know. And to get away on Slauson and Crenshaw at 3 p.m., I go by his store every day. Not once a week, not twice a week, not three times a week, every day. And it's impossible to get away with a crime like that. Impossible. Because if he was shot 6 times and 2 other people were shot, I have no doubt. If that crime took 5 seconds, I don't know if it was a semi-automatic, automatic weapon. Someone saw it, but they obviously want to remain anonymous. And I understand where they're coming from. So, and, you know, quote unquote gang retaliation. And here's what I believe on some level. Even if it was a gang member that did it, he was paid by a higher source. Someone advocated on his behalf to do this. Someone convinced him financially to do this to Nipsey, because how were you able to just strategically just shoot him 6 times, you know, and not just spray the gun everywhere, you know? I'm just saying, man. Obviously, thoughts and prayers go to the family and immediate friends, and you know, he touched so many lives, man. And I know I speak for many people on YouTube and many people in the real world that he was our brother, you know, and it just hurts, man. I admire and revere what he did to this date, and I'm hurt because he had so much more to give, so much more potential, so many more albums to write, so many more raps to sing that would have healed our city and healed our nation. I have no doubt, and it would have inspired so many black men to be black men. And in addition to a great platform, he had economic clout, and he was putting it back in our community. And I admire that, and that's why I revere him. That's why I have the same desires, you know. His album was simply amazing, man. I don't want this to get too repetitive, but his album, man, this is why, you know, there was a story out yesterday about Pulev. That's why I don't give two shits about Pulev. Black men and white men are not equal in this country. I don't have time to give emotional equity to a white man. I don't. I don't have that type of equity or time in my life. You know, I'm like everyone else. I wish I could have detoured his life just 1 second. It probably would have derailed everything that would could have happened today. You know, would have offset the time, you know. You know, it's just beside me, you know. And that tweet, who says he posted that tweet? Just being real. I mean, I don't, man. I have no doubt trees are going to grow from this today. We're going to be stronger. We're going to be better for it. And let's love one another, man. And let's honor our brotherhood to one another, man. Man, I love y'all, and I just want y'all to fully grasp and understand that you living out your full potential makes us better. Okay? I'll say it again. You living out to your fullest potential makes us better. So get there. All right? And prayers out to his family and friends, is, you know, this is the, I would say, the hardest external family thing that I've ever had to go through, man. And it kind of, it zapped me all day. Like, my heart dropped when I got that text from my neighbor, you know. My heart literally just dropped. Man, you have no idea. I mean, I probably ran about anywhere between 400 and 600 miles to Nipsey Hussle last year. You know, his album came out February 16th, and why I know that, because that's the same day Black Panther came out. I was covering the Danny Garcia, Brandon Rios fight in Las Vegas. I remember that week vividly. And, you know. Saw Black Panther in Vegas. Yeah. Mm. Anywho, man, have a great night. Love your brother, man. Protect your brother. Teach your kids the truth. Yeah. And be fearless. Loving yourself makes you fearless. And, you know, barbershop conversations, man. I'll probably come back with another video tomorrow as it relates to this, because I just can't wrap my brain around this one. Like, I literally can't wrap my brain. It doesn't make sense to me. But when you strive to be great, when you strive to be independently great as a Black man and not be codependent upon them funneling money and channeling your finances and controlling your finances, they gonna come for you, you know. So whether it was a Black man who did it, a white man who did it, I have no doubt it came from somewhere else. So anyways, man, I love y'all. Barbershop Conversations, man. Feel free to hit the subscribe button. Thank you, Nipsey Hussle. You inspired an entire generation. No doubt, in just 33 years, you inspired an entire generation on how to promote, how to write an album, how to make a complete album. You know, if women in America wasn't the largest consumers, Nipsey Hussle would have had album of the year. Cardi B beat him out. But Nipsey Hussle, man, you saved and touched a lot of lives, man. Be proud. I know you're probably up in heaven telling people it's better up here than it is down there, you know. So anyways, man, Barbershop Conversation for the 35th time. And thank you, Nipsey Hussle. We love you. And album of the year, man. Flat out, album of the year. Peace. Man of the year. Man of the year.